What's going on, my exotic family? It's your boy Dre, back at you with another video. So today's video is basically, this is going to be the first video of the care video series. So basically, I talked about a couple of my other videos that I wanted to do a series basically just focusing on strictly the care of each of the animals I have. So welcome to the first part of that series. And as you can see in the title, today's animal is going to be all about blood pythons. So let's jump right into it. So blood pythons are the biggest of the Sumatran python family. So you have your Sumatran short tail pythons, you have your Borneo pythons, and then you have your blood python. Blood pythons usually average anywhere from 4 to 5 feet. So they make a great snake for someone who wants a larger snake, but not too big without them, you know, without having to get into like some of the larger pythons, like your Burmese and your reticulated pythons and anything like that. Alrighty, so next we'll jump into housing. So for a hatchling blood python, I would recommend personally nothing smaller than a 20 long. They are terrestrial, so they're going to want more length than height. I'm not going to say they aren't climbers. They're not known to be climbers. They're not huge active climbers. I mean, my blood python Kato, I keep a piece of wood in there, and he doesn't really care to go up on it, which, I mean, they are heavy body snakes, so that makes sense. But basically, you want to start off in something, you know, like a 20 long or something equivalent. They are kind of, you know, private snakes, I guess you can, say. They're not super active snakes. So me personally, I started my blood python off in a tub. He started off in actually the rack behind me. Those are 28 quart tubs. So he stayed in that. When I got him, he was already, I want to say, like 6 months or so. So he only stayed in the rack for like another 6 months, and then I upgraded him into his current enclosure, which is up there, the black one that you can see. That's a 3 foot PVC enclosure. And even from there, I'm actually preparing to move him into something a little bit bigger. I'm looking at a 4x2x2 enclosure. I'll either build it myself, or I've been seeing a few cages here and there that I got my eye on. However, as far as caging, a blood python adult size, the 4x2x2 is the minimum for an adult blood python. So next we'll jump into heating and temperature. Blood pythons usually like it kind of like the mid to low 80s. Kato here, I keep him usually right around like 80 to 82 ambient, with a hot spot at right around 88. The humidity I keep right around 70 to 80%. They are burrowing snakes, so I also make sure I include a nice little hide in their form. That's also going to help with humidity when shedding. To be honest, I rarely see Kato unless I actually pull him out of his enclosure. Kato, for the most part, kind of just stays hidden, tucked away, unless most of you that do know, blood pythons love to soak. So the only time I see Kato out is if he's in his water bowl, pail, whatever. It's one of those plastic shoe bins. So he can fit his whole body inside of it. So that's usually when I can tell he's about to shed. He'll usually soak in that for like 2 to 3 days. And then he'll kind of just go into his hide, and he'll just stay in there for the remainder of his shedding until he sheds. So what I usually like to do is spray pretty good under his hide just to keep it humid, and then spray down the rest of his enclosure just to keep the humidity up in there as well. So next we'll talk about substrate, since that kind of ties into humidity. You can use, you know, a plethora of substrates with blood pythons. You know, Eco Earth, some people use cypress mulch or a mixture of both. Some people use newspaper, paper towel. I personally use ReptiChip. The other ones I named are also very good substrates as well. I use ReptiChip. I like it. I haven't had any issues with it, so that just seems to work for me. I used Eco Earth before, not with any of my snakes. I use it for the tortoise that we have. I just felt like the ReptiChip was a little bit easier. Since I feed frozen inside the enclosure, I don't have to really worry about it, you know, sticking to the food or anything like that. Eco Earth, they drop the rat, you know, it's just covered in dirt. And I know they'll pass it through for the most part. That's just me and my OCD. It bothered me, so I chose ReptiChip. So I choose Repti. I use Repti chip, and it holds humidity very well. And if I spray it down in the morning, then I generally don't have to spray that enclosure again for like maybe 2 to 3 days. So that's something that I really do like about the Repti chip. And then lastly, I mean, it's basically diet. Diet is, I mean, obviously they're heavy body snakes, and since they are heavy body snakes, a lot of people feel like you have to like feed them a lot, and that is not true. Blood pythons, you don't have to give them a huge meal. Kato eats every 10 to 14 days at this point, and he does perfectly fine. I mean, when I got him, he was like 150 grams. He was tiny, and now he's a year and a couple months, and he's on small rats every 10 to 14 days, and this guy's up to like almost 1200 grams. So I feel like as long as you're consistent with it and you keep the temperatures and humidity right, I mean, as long as your setup is right, and I mean, that's for any reptile, you won't have any issues. So what I'll go ahead now and do, guys, is we went over everything, and I'll show you the setup that I have for Kato and how it compares with everything I just talked about.
All right, everybody. So this is Kato's enclosure. Like I said, it's 3-foot PVC enclosure. It's got its basking bulb up there, which I know some people are frowning upon the bulb. It's fine. I know I just kind of had to work with what I had, but like I said, he'll be getting a new enclosure soon. So I'm actually going to be in that enclosure. He'll have the radiant heat panel. I just didn't feel the need to spend the money to kind of rig this one up how I wanted, because there's a particular animal that will go in here that I want to keep the bulb for. But for now, I mean, it works. I don't have any issues with temperature. Humidity stays up. Here's the log that I was talking about. He doesn't use it. I mean, he, you know, will crawl under it, but I guess that's more so for me. It's good for aesthetics. But I mean, that's basically it. And then see if I can show you guys Kato. He is currently in shed, for those of you that were wondering, which is why I didn't have him out for the video. So this is Kato. As you can see, Kato is getting some size. But for the most part, I mean, he does pretty good in here. Like I said, he has a pretty big water dish. But if he's not in the water dish, he spends his time under his hide right here. So, I mean, that's basically it, guys, for blood python care. They're not too hard to care for. A lot of people feel like they are super duper aggressive and they are out to kill you and blah, 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 blah. And that is not the case at all. I feel like every snake is going to be different, but I mean, if you expect every snake to be kind of, you know, puppy dog tame, that's just not possible. And even furthermore, you have to handle every reptile in order to get the outcome that you would like. And guys, with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. I really appreciate you guys watching. Your support really means a lot. Always leave a comment, like, hit that notification bell. I'm open to ideas or suggestions, and definitely be on the lookout for more, you know, care videos. Like I said, this is video one of care videos. I have multiple reptiles that I can do care videos on, and I would love to know what you guys would like to see next. And then if you aren't following me, make sure you hit me up on Instagram at DW Exotics, just like my YouTube name on here. I'm always posting daily updates on there of a lot of my pets. Definitely look out for that, and we'll see you next time.